Hello, so this is the last video about knight of 3d5 c4, what is called Reti, and the other videos will be about our repertoire against knight of 3d5, and they will be called against Indian attack. But this is all the part of knight of 3d5 repertoire, but let's finish with this d4. And now, what to do against e3, knight c6, and e takes d4. Well, this is White's main idea. It was described in the Deutschow-Semkov book about Reti. So, something has changed over this 5 or 6 years. Knight d4, knight takes d4, and queen takes d4. Black's main idea is actually to play knight h6 and knight h5, taking control over d4 square. Sometimes black plays e5, sometimes g6. It depends on the position. If white here tries bishop e2, then the best move is knight h6, and after knight c3, the game transposes into our main line. If d3, also knight h6, we don't afraid bishop take h6. We will see why in the nearest future. And here, what happens if white plays knight d2 at some point, not knight c3? For example, bishop e2, knight f5. If castles, then it's good moment to play e5. Why? Because after knight d2, bishop e7, rook e1 castles, knight b3, queen d6, we control the center, bishop d2 and f6, more control, queen c2, bishop e6, bishop f3 and rook e8, with an equal position we attack d3 pawn. And if knight d2, then what happens? We play g6, because white wants to play knight f3 very quick. We should control the d4 square also very quick. Knight f3 and queen d6. What's the problem of d4 now? Because if not d4, then bishop g7 is full control. The problem is that after bishop g7, white center fails. For example, c5, queen d5, bishop e3, and e5. This thematical blow in the center. D takes e5, knight e3, f takes e3, and queen c5, queen d4, and queen e7. And black is better because the pawn will fall in the nearest future. And if bishop d2, then just bishop g7, bishop c3, that was white's idea, and just castle. Because if white does nothing, for example, rook c1, then c5, or castle, then c5, and black establishes full control over d4 square, so d4 and b6. Castles, bishop b7, and with the idea rook d8, c5 at some point, and black is slightly better. Let's move on. Knight c3, the main line, c6, d3, and knight h6. That move was not heavily analyzed in the Semkov-Deutschow's books. Actually, maybe it's white who must be careful in this position. Many moves from here on. Let's start with the minor ones. Bishop. Oh, sorry, knight e2. Then queen b6. What's the idea? After knight g3, that is the point of white's play. Just e5, taking the center. Bishop e2, knight f5. If knight f5, bishop f5, castles and bishop c5, and boy is better due to the control over d4 square. And if castles, then knight g3, hg, and bishop c5, rook b1, e5, taking b4 square under control, bishop f3, castles with an equal position. Oh, sorry, black is slightly better. Bishop h6 is a typical mistake because black now has pair of bishops, g takes h6, bishop h2, and rook g8, taking over g file. Maybe the best try is g3, but then bishop f5, preparing castle one. But bishop f3 is a bad move. Bishop f5, queen a4. The game of Grandmaster Korneev, and he should play castle queenside, and black is just much better due to this weak pawn. So never afraid of taking on h6. Let's move on. h3. Knight f5. So if white does nothing like bishop e2, then just e5, taking control over d4 square. G4 is the point of white's move h3, but just queen e5 intermediate check, and black is better. For example, if queen e2, queen e2, if bishop e2, then knight d4, if knight e2, then knight h4, bishop b3, and striking h5, gh, rook h5, castle g6, knight g3, rook h8, and black is better, like in the Grandmaster Ovechkin's game with black. If knight e4, then knight d4, f4, the game knight h-bauer, 2011, queen c7, bishop e3, and e5, another strike in the center, bishop d4, takes d4, f5, bishop b4, very nasty check, king f2 and bishop e7, black is just better, because black has pair of bishops, and white's king is vulnerable. Another try, bishop e2, solid move, knight f5. If g4 again, then it's another idea, because no queen e5 check, but just knight h4, rook g1, and queen d6, taking h2 pawn, rook g3, the game of hammer with black. Here black should try e5, taking the center, and after bishop e3, another strike, f5, gf, knight f5, rook g2, knight e3, f takes e3, and queen h6, king d2, bishop f5, with the idea of castle. So it's not a great position at all for white. If castles, then just e5, and now white should play g4, because otherwise black has full control over d4 square. For example, knight e4, bishop e7, bishop d2, and a typical move by queen, but now on d8, queen d8. So the idea, bishop c3, knight d4. If f4, striking in the center, then he takes f4. Rook takes f4. Knight d4 or bishop f4, maybe it's slightly better, because white develops a piece. Castles, queen d2, knight d4, rook e1, f5, knight c3. b6, bishop d1, bishop b7, with the idea c5, so black is slightly better. If g4 in this position, then white can be under pressure after knight h4, bishop e3, and now not queen d8, but even better, queen d7. What the idea? h5, and if white takes, then queen h3. If f4, it takes f4, rook f4, bishop e7, d4, castles, and black is slightly better. If d4, taking control over the center, then h5 is our idea. So h3 is too slow, h takes g4, h takes g4, and great move, knight f5 with serious attack. So f3 should be played. It takes d4, and if bishop takes d4, just very unpleasant position. H takes g4, f takes g4, and queen c7, black wants to castle one, rook f2, bishop e6, queen b3, castles, bishop a7, bishop d6, and black's attack is awesome. If white plays bishop b6, it's just a losing move due to bishop takes h2 and rook h2, then queen g3 with decisive attack. So white should trade the queens. Queen d4, queen d4, bishop d4, bishop e6, knight d4, but black's attack continues in the endgame. Knight g6, b3, f6, protecting g7 pawn. If knight c5, then knight f4, rook a1, king f7. If knight b7, then bishop b4, bishop b3, takes on a1, bishop f4, bishop b4. Black wins the exchange, and if knight e6, then just knight e6, bishop e3, and rook e8. And due to white's vulnerable pawn structure, black is slightly better. So, another good move for white, bishop e3, but even here, black has no problems. Castles g5, f5, knight c5, and a good defensive move. Knight f4, bishop f4, bishop c5, king g2, g6. It was a game in internet. I think maybe something like a center game of this using of engines, because very the game has this game has very high quality, and the position is equal, but I understand that many very precise move by white, like queen d4 in this particular moment, b3 at this particular moment, and then bishop e3. So not very easy in the practical game to make all these moves. And the main line is of course bishop e3, attacking the queen. Black plays queen d8. So if not d4, then knight f5. If bishop h6 here, the idea is that queen on d8 may be misplaced. Then nothing very useful for white. Anyway, g takes h6. If bishop to bishop g7, controlling d4 square, so d4 is a must. Bishop g7, d5. Zvyagintsev against Granda Zuniga. And black could play rook g8 here, just asking white how you protect g2 pawn if you move your bishop anywhere. So if g3, then queen b6 attacking b2 pawn, queen d2, bishop f5, bishop g2, c takes d5. Of course, knight d5 is a blunder due to queen takes b2, so c takes d5, and queen d4, black exchanges the queens, queen d4, bishop d4, castles, rook c8, rook c1, and rook g6, bringing rook into the play. Black is slightly better. If queen c2 instead of g3, then c takes d5, and knight d5, e6. If queen h7, that's okay. King f8, knight c3, and bishop d7 with the idea of bishop c6, and how to develop with white, I don't know. This bishop is too powerful, and this bishop would be powerful either. So, knight c3, queen a5. If castles, then bishop d7, g3, bishop c6, rook g1, rook c8, and black has nasty attack. And if g3, then bishop d7, bishop g2, and important move, queen e5, asking white to stay in the center. If king f1, castles, and black is better, and if knight e2, then black just takes on b2, queen b2, bishop b2, rook b1, bishop e5, bishop b7, rook b8, king d2, and bishop c7, and black is slightly better due to the pair of bishops. So don't afraid of bishop h6, d4 must be played, knight f5. But that's the problem of bishop e3 move, that this bishop is now misplaced. If bishop e2, just don't take queen e3 immediately, g6, make useful moves, castles, maybe a slight inaccuracy. Bishop g7, d5, knight e3, f takes e3, and castles and black is slightly better. Queen d2, g6. In Vaitashek's game, his opponent played d5, and Vaitashek should have played knight takes e3, queen takes e3, bishop g7, bishop e2, and here comes the point, bishop, sorry, queen b6, the idea to exchange the queens, queen d2, and castles on black is better. If castles, bishop g7, bishop e2, castles h4, that was Navarra's game with black, and here David should have played b5, just taking the c4 pawn. This idea comes from the Karakhan defense, h5 and queen a5, with the idea before this pawn would hang, so c takes b5 is a must, c takes b5. Bishop b5, bishop b7, h takes g6, h takes g6, and black has full compensation for the sacrifice pawn, so these files are opened. White is under attack. Maybe bishop b2 is the best solution. Bishop g7, rook d1, castles, castles. And black is slightly better. Queen a5, d5. That's a good moment to take on e3. Queen takes e3 and queen b6, just another exchange of queens. Queen d2, maybe that's the moment where white can equalize by precise play. Queen e7, queen b2, knight e4, cd5, cd5, bishop f5, and the position is more or less equal. But in the game, Bielawski-Littau, white played queen d2, and black should have played bishop f5, bishop f3, rook e8, rook f1, rook f8, and black has a pair of bishops, and that's a slight advantage for black. So let's make some conclusions. Just play knight h6, then e5 or g6, bishop g7, and control the square. And white is the side that must be careful not to be in a dangerous position after the opening. That's all about the ready with knight f3, d5, c4, and see you in the next videos where we will discuss the King's Indian attack after the second move g3. Thanks for watching this video and see you again soon. Goodbye.